Good morning. Please stand.
In behalf of all gathered, on behalf of St. Mary's, St. Francis, behalf of the community of All Saints, now St. Mary Academy, our deepest sympathies to all of Jim's family, of course, his wife Eleanor, to each of the daughters, to Maisie, to Bridget, son-in-law Matt, brother and sister Debbie and Vinny, all the other members of his family and also friends and neighbors. So sorry for your sadness. May God be with you and give you peace and comfort. It is indeed a day of sadness. I invite us also to come together as a people of faith, particularly as we approach the holy day of Easter, the resurrection of our Lord, and maybe find comfort and hope in that. And so in that spirit of faith, let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant James, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
For the first reading, we'd like to call upon Maisie, please.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hands of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For in the eyes of men, indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As God in the furnace, he proved them, and sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall.
the second reading. I'd like to call upon Matt, please.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be aware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest of us who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead of Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, in the truth, in the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We've lost a good man. And I know it still does not seem possible. It's still so difficult to believe. A man who was just so active, he was also healthy, just so hard to believe how quickly things can change. My sympathies and prayers to you. There's a beautiful tradition, not really well known, and hasn't necessarily really taken off, but we all know that when someone gets married, there's the tradition of the bachelor party, or now the bachelorette party. There's another tradition that really is born and takes place more in terms of charismatic circles, and the tradition is called an honoring party. And in that circumstance, what they do when they gather in preparation for the wedding, they gather together to honor that man who will become a husband, that woman who will become a wife. And I share that with you and suggest that maybe that's why we're here today, that this is Jim's honoring party. And if there was time, each and every one of you could stand up and honor Jim, Mr. Carr. Now, the reality is, I know, certainly myself, we think he belongs to us. We have our relationship with him. But he first belonged to you. Eleanor, what a great husband. What a great partner. What a great friend. We honor him as truly a great husband. To Maisie and Bridget, you don't need us to tell you. You had a great dad. Thanks be to God to have a wonderful man to be your father. To his brother and sister, that loving brother. Because when you think about all the things that we can accomplish in this world, begins at home. Sadly, there's a tragedy of many people who do great things, and God bless. What about the home? What about their family? A great family man, husband and dad. We honor Jim. And you were nice enough to share him with all of us. And many people knew him in many different capacities, for many and perhaps maybe even most here, as a teacher through the school. And many are here from All Saints Regional Catholic School, now St. Mary Academy. What an impact he made on that community. He truly was and is a tour de force. Now, we all know those who have had the wonderful association with that school community. Sister Jeanette, what a great job she did. The matron of that school. But sorry, sister. In many respects, Mr. Carr is his school. We have had many great teachers, but somehow he was the teacher. There was just something about him. Recently thinking, I saw again one of my great movies, Kindergarten Cop. And Mr. Kimball, who was a police officer, parading as a kindergarten teacher. And in the beginning, he's like overwhelmed, but then he kind of gets his act together and his inner police kicks in. And he has control of the kids. When Mr. Carr walked into a room, it was his room. He was in control. And not in a harsh way, but just in the way that he radiated a sense of authority. And people respected him. But what a teacher. What a teacher. What a gift he has been. And when someone had been a student of Mr. Carr, they took something with them. And they did well. And his innovations and his additions, hydroponics, robotics. I'll never forget the day behind our Paris Center here, setting off those rockets. A talented man who shared that so beautifully with his students. There was just something about him. And so that's why I say, in many respects, it was his school. In many respects, he was the teacher, Mr. Carr. Remember many years ago, in my first parish, one of my responsibilities was visiting the local hospital. And of all things, who did I run into? My old seventh grade teacher, who I always respected. And I remember he asked me, he said, "What do you remember?" And he was a science teacher. And I said, "I couldn't remember anything," even though he taught us a lot. And I said, "But I remember you." Because he was a good man. The same is true of Mr. Carr, the students who are here, and many that he touched. They will always remember Mr. Carr. He left something behind. And that's why when the news rippled out, what a shock. What a shock. So this wonderful family man, this great teacher, and such an active and talented man, all the things that he enjoyed in life and his retirement. And in St. Mary Academy, we wanted more than anything for him to continue on. But it was time for him to retire, which he enjoyed, with many of the things that he enjoyed. Very active, was flying or windsurfing or other things. God bless. And here we are. But we honor him. And we thank him. And we thank God. But we also thank God we have our faith. When the eve of Holy Week and Easter, we're celebrating not just a drama that happened many, many years ago, but the drama that is with us here today because we believe that Jesus is risen from the dead and is with us. And that belief gives us hope and shines our way to a better future and a new day. And what does it mean to have faith? It doesn't mean that we have all the answers. It doesn't mean that we don't cry. It doesn't mean that this doesn't hurt. But we believe. And as Jim did so beautifully, we express that faith. The way we treat people. The kind of person that we are. The way we help lend a hand. That's all an expression of faith. It begins at the altar, but they take it out into the world to share with others. But a faith also gives us hope. And in a simple sentence, we can boldly say, this isn't over. This isn't over. As Christians, we are not saying goodbye because we believe in the resurrection, not just of Jesus, but our resurrection. May we find hope and comfort as we sadly honor this wonderful man. It's a lousy day outside. God bless those who came from the island. Hopefully you don't need a boat to get back. But you know what? Good. Because this lousy weather fits our mood. That's what we feel like. A lousy day. But I share this with you, and I've shared this many, many times. My younger brother lives in Tennessee. And I try to visit him about once a year. And most of the time, now he's a retired teacher himself. And so I'll go during his spring break in March. And I remember one day going, it was a day just like this, a lousy day. And when I fly, I like to have a window seat. And this particular day, I got on the plane, got my window seat, and this is what I see. And this had never happened before, so it really took me by surprise. But you know, when the plane takes off, it has to get higher and higher to get to the altitude to reach its destination. And so we're getting higher and higher. I'm looking out, I'm seeing the rain, and all of a sudden we're in the clouds. And all of a sudden, we were above the storm. The clouds were below us. There was no more rain. And I could see the sun in the distance. Now, not only was that a cool experience, but for me, that's kind of like a human image of what we believe in the resurrection. To pierce the storms and the clouds and rain of this world, behold the face of God. To be at peace and to wait for our loved ones to join us in the kingdom of God. So we imagine this little amateur pilot making his final flight, flying above the storms and clouds of this world, beholding the face of God and to wait for us. It's a sad day. We've lost a good man in many, many ways. And so we honor him, first and foremost, as a wonderful family man, husband, dad, brother. And so many of us who knew him in many, many other capacities, Mr. Carr, thank you. Your impact will always be with us. We honor him. But as Christians, we don't say goodbye. We commend him to God. And with belief in the resurrection, we imagine him soaring above the storms of this world, beholding the face of God, to one day wait for us. God bless. Let us stand for our prayer of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
For James, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For our brother who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother James, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here who worship in faith, that we may be gathered again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Returning love for
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant James, we beseech your mercy, that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are the holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you
and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant James, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. To him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Rise.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Or be seated. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The Holy Communion, those that are Catholic, prepare to receive. There will be four stations, two in the front and two at the heads of the aisle here. If you're not receiving, you may simply remain in your pew in prayer. Or if you would like to come forward and you're not receiving, just put your hand over your heart, we'll know that, and give you a blessing. Remind ourselves, I noticed many, many times on a sad day like this, it's so easy to be distracted and we kind of forget ourselves. But if you are receiving, as soon as you receive the host first, place the body of Christ on your mouth before beginning to walk away. Thank you.
Oh,
Here at St. Mary's, we have the tradition of our book of remembrance. We want to write Jim's name now in that book that he's remembered to pray for us. I'll invite Eleanor, one of the family, to come forward to write his name for us. Or you can all come up.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Please rise and let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother James may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
May the angels be your guide. May they lead you into paradise and take you home to the New Jerusalem. There is one thing I ask of God, for this I long, for this I hope, to dwell
into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother James in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon James in his life. They are signs to us of your goodness and the fellowship within the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise for your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we meet in Christ, or all with you and with our brother and sister forever and ever.
Amen.
We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Everlasting love to join them. And may your grace